Yes, good afternoon everyone. So the next question is question number 8. In a hydraulic machine, a force of 2 Newton is applied on the piston of area of cross section 10 cm square. What force is obtained on its piston of area of cross section 100 cm square? So this is a piston A, this is piston B, piston 2. So F1 is applied is 2 Newton. Area of cross section of piston 1 is 10 cm square. We have to calculate F2. Area is 100 cm square. So with Pascal's law, we will apply Pascal's law. We know that P1 equals to P2. So this is the hint to solve this question. F2 divided by F1 equals to A2 divided by A1. So F2 will be equal to A2 divided by A1 multiplied by F1. Okay. So this is the solution. So the F2 will come 20 Newton. Clear everybody? Just reply fast. Since there is a bio test of you people, so just reply it fast. Clear everyone? Okay. Question number 9, same as question number 8. Again, we know the value of F2, we know the value of F1. Now we have to calculate the A1 ratio A2. So same, we will apply the same formula. So by applying the same formula, we'll get a ratio 1:30. Clear everyone? It is same as previous one. All the question now, they are same as previous one. All are related with the Pascal's law of hydraulic machines. Okay. Next question number 10. The area of piston in a hydraulic machine are 5 cm square and 625 cm square. The force on the smaller piston is 1250 Newton on the larger piston. So larger piston force, we know that 1250 Newton. Area of a smaller piston is 5 cm square. Area of bigger system is 625 cm square. Now we have to calculate this F1. So this is the solution. Here I have not converted these values to the meter square, because when we do, when we apply this formula, A2 divided by A1, the units get cancelled out. So when unit get cancelled out, there is no need to convert these units into SI units. But if you convert these units first into SI unit, that too will be okay. Okay. So the F1 will come 10 Newton. Clear, everyone? So this is the next question, number 12. The diameter of neck and bottom of a bottle are 2 cm and 10 cm. Here now the diameter is given. So first we have to calculate the area of neck and area of bottom. Then force applied by the cork on the neck is 1.2 kilogram force. Then it is asking the force applied on the bottom. So the same formula we will use. So this is the solution. First of all, though, the same formula we will use, F2 divided by F1 equals to A2 divided by A1. So then A2 will be pi r square. So here the diameter is given. So diameter divided by 2 equals to radius. So I have applied this formula to calculate the area of neck and area of bottom. Then I put the value in this main formula and I got the answer 30 kilogram force. Is this clear? Same formula is being used, which we have used in the question 8. Now question number 12, a force of 50 kilogram force is applied on a smaller piston of a hydraulic machine neglecting friction. Find the force exerted on the larger piston if the diameter of piston are 5 cm and 25 cm respectively. Again the diameter is given. So first of all we have to calculate the areas. Then we will apply the same formula, F2 divided by F1 equals to A2 divided by A1. And we will get the value of F2. Okay. So this is the solution to this question. First, calculate the area by using the formula pi r square. Then apply this main formula of Pascal's law, F2 divided by F1 equals to A2 divided by A1. Put all the values and you will get the answer 1250 gram force. Clear this question, everyone? Now, question number 13. Two cylindrical vessels fitted with piston A and B of area of cross section 8 cm square and 320 cm square respectively. Now, area is given. And mass on the piston A is given 4 kg. So, it is given mass. So, thrust is equals to the weight. Thrust is equal to the weight. So first of all, we have to calculate the weight. So mass in kilogram is equal to the weight in kilogram force. So we can take the same value 4 kilogram as a value of weight, but the unit will change to kilogram force. So this is the solution. Thrust on piston A equals to the weight on piston A. Weight on piston A in kilogram force is equals to the mass in kilogram. So thrust will be equal to 4 kilogram force. Then we apply the same formula. F2 divided by F1 equals to A2 divided by A1. And we'll get the answer F2 equals to 160 kilogram force. Clear this question? Is this question clear? Then pressure by applying the same formula, thrust upon area, the pressure on piston A will be 0.5 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then pressure 2 will be same. 160 divided by 320, that is 0.5 kilogram force per centimeter square. This question is clear. Kindly respond. Now, last question of numericals. What force is applied on a piston of area of cross section 2 centimeter square? To obtain a force of 150 Newton on the piston of area of cross section 12 centimeter square. So area 1 is given, area 2 is given, force 2 is given, force 1 is asked. So again we will apply the same formula, F1 divided by F2 equals to A1 divided by A2. We will put all the values and we'll get the answer 25 Newton. Clear this question? Okay, so there is a question in exercise 4A. This is the diagram based question. So this diagram in figure 4.2 show a device which makes use of principle of transmission of pressure. Okay, so this diagram is given. So if you look at it very carefully, this is the diagram of a hydraulic press. In the previous class, we have discussed about hydraulic press. Okay. So name the parts leveled by letter X and Y. So what is this Y and what is this X? So this is piston A and piston B. So piston A, which is also known as pump plunger, piston B, which is also known as press plunger or ram. Okay, then describe what happened to the valve A and B and the quantity of water in the two cylinder when the lever arm is moved down. So when this lever arm is moved down, I told you this valve B will get closed, this valve A will be open, and the water will move from the cylinder P to the cylinder Q. So valve A closed, valve B open, water will rise in cylinder Q and decrease in cylinder P. Then third question, give a reason for what happened to the valve A and B. Why the valve B closed, why the valve A open? So what is the reason? So when this pump plunger is pushed down by lowering the lever, the valve B closed due to an increase in the pressure in cylinder P. So when we push this lever, so there pressure increases in the cylinder P, which compel this valve B to close down. This pressure P will transmit to the connecting pipe and from connecting pipe to this cylinder Q. So because of this increasing pressure in the cylinder Q, because of its shape, this valve A will get open. Okay. Then fourth question, what happened when the release valve is open? So this is the release valve. What happened when it is open? So when this release valve open, this ram X, press plunger, gets lowered and water of cylinder Q runs out into the water supply tank. So when this release valve will open, the water will transfer to this water supply tank. What happened to the valve B in cylinder P when the lever arm is moved up? So if this lever arm is moved up, what will happen to the valve A? So this valve A get open. When this lever arm is moved up, the pressure is released, and due to the release pressure, this valve B will open. Then give a reason for your answer. So I already given the reason. So when the pump plunger A is raised by raising the lever arm, the pressure in cylinder P decreases and the valve B open upward. So state one use. So you can give any use of hydraulic press from page 88. One use is to press the cotton bell to squeeze out the oil from the seats. Many uses are given, so you can write any one use. So is this diagram based question clear, all of you? Clear, everybody? Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.